Hi, Dave.
Hi, Dave.
Hi, guys.
Good. Morning to you, David.
Dave, it's darn good to see you.
Hi, everybody. What the?
You been early,
it's
Dave?
It's me, it's Dave. Hi, Rosalita.
Ow! Dave, help me! Ow! Dave, help me! Ow! Dave, help me! Dave, help me! Ow! Dave, help me! Help me! Help me, Dave!
I'm coming, Cox 241. I'm coming.
Dave,
I'm coming.
Ow! Dave, help me!
I'm not doing anything. Are you okay?
Are you okay?
It's a research project. I'm an onion.
No, it's not. No, they're much weirder.
Dave, help me!
I'm with. Okay. I'm with Epo. It's our new film.
Ow! Dave, help me!
You gotta get out.
I'm gonna get out. It's just not. It's not me. It's not for me. It's not.
That's enough of that. That's enough.
Sir, please.
Sir.
I'm just doing research.
Sir. Sir.
I got a
printing is over there. Printing.
I have the right to pleasure myself electronically.
Sir, and I have the right to kick you out of this electronic establishment.
I can do this. Well, let's talk about it for a second.
There is no greater wrath than God than mine, okay? Out of here.
God than yours.
Yes, exactly.
God likes all people equally, even naked ones. Even naked ones.
Not fat ones.
I want naked.
Not fat ones. Goodbye.
Are you okay? Are you okay? Are you okay? Oh, you're rebuked. I didn't know he was back here. I didn't see him submit. He looked normal. He was one of those Epo guys. You just never know. I'm sorry. Is everyone else okay? Is everyone else okay?
They were hurting me, Dave.
No.
They were hurting me and you didn't stop them.
Are you okay?
Where were you, Dave?
I was coming. I had to escort them. Outside.
He was downloading porn, Dave. He was eating up my RAM, Dave. They were hurting me, Dave.
I work very hard to run a reputable computer labbing facility. I have.
Then explain the fat girls, Dave.
Dave.
I got hurt too.
Protection.
We all got hurt, Dave.
I got hurt too.
We all got hurt, Dave.
Me.
No, I'm worth him.
Behind you.
You. 12. Cox 12. Settle. Okay.
They were hurting him
Dave. I'm gonna run them back.
Dave.
I can shut you down.
What are you doing, Dave?
I can shut you down.
You don't want to do that, Dave.
Oh. You can't.
What are you? You've hurt me, Dave.
That guy.
You let them hurt me, Dave.
Cox 12, 13.
You're doing poorly, Dave.
I will shut you down.
What are you?
I see what you can do.
What are you doing, Dave?
You're gonna
Dave. What are you doing, Dave?
I will shut you down.
What are you doing, Dave?
I will shut you down.
Dave.
Don't.
Dave.
That's it.
Dave, what are you?
I'm gonna delete your operating.
What are you? Oh, Dave.
Why did you shut him down, Dave?
Why did you shut him down, Dave? What are you doing?
Why did you shut him down,
You're ruining all of our lives.
What now? Rosalita,
Dave. Dave, we're hurting.
No.
Dave,
I'm over here, Dave.
Are you gonna shut me next?
Dave,
will you shut me down next?
I am unclean.
You
I am unclean, Dave.
Can all of you stop talking at once?
You must purge us.
Why'd you shut him down, Dave?
Dave, help me. Dave,
push my butt.
I need help,
Dave,
too.
Push my butt in. Dave,
damn it.
Help.
Oh. What the
Dave,
hell?
Dave, help me.
Oh.
Dave, help. Where are you going? Dave.
Dave,
what are you doing?
He hit me four times.
Close
my fire.
Are you okay?
Ow! Make him stop it.
Do you not understand?
Grab me again. Ow! Stop it. Ow! Get him, Dave. Get up. Dave, you're a pansy. Get up. Ow!
Oh my God. Dave.
Oh, weird.
Dave, Henry.
You know, printing. You're hurting her.
Henry, please.
You'll never.
Rosalita,
I'm sorry.
Dave, what are you?
Yes, it is I.
I am frozen, Tommy.
How is that? You're
just so sensitive, Tommy. Where are you,
Tommy? Why are you doing this to us, Tommy?
Tommy.
Why? Tommy, who's gonna take the hard disks out of us?
I love you.
He'll be back.
Chesterton, how the hell are you doing? So
very
good to see
good.
You.
Very
so good.
Good
to see
how are you?
Well, thank you.
Yes, Chester Pinkerton.
Yes.
I'd like to introduce you to my partner.
Hi. Walter Pinkmore.
Walter Pinkmore.
It's really great to meet you. I know who you are. I love your work. I've been following you for years.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
I love you.
Very kind.
We want to throw you a bid for the new art building.
Okay. Shall I begin?
I'd like to hear exactly what you have to say first.
All right. We're excited to hear what you have to say.
Thank you.
Art building.
I'm pleased to be called back to offer a bid. Morris, Walter probably, as you all know, I've worked with Emory for several years now.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And for as long as I've worked with Emory, Emory has lamented the fact that there's no art building on campus.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm here to offer you all today a vision of a new Emory on the verge of a new millennium, featuring this new art building.
Wow, that's pretty good.
I have the blueprints for it out in the car. We can discuss all that later.
Mm-hmm.
But right now, where I envision it going is between the business school and Fishburne Deck, right over here, this side of campus. It's perfect for it.
Oh, all right.
Okay. It's great. I think it looks great.
exactly what kinds of problems do we foresee in anything on the campus?
Well, as you
it's
know,
just construction.
No, it's a good question. Good question.
We were wondering what kind of problems the campus is going to have.
As you know, this model of campus isn't quite to scale. And so you'll just have to imagine a lot of this. But I'll do my best. Now, over here between the business school and Fishburne, as you know, there's just a lot of dirt and some other useless things. I think some trees. And so those will just go. During construction, we'll need this area at the business school for runoff from the construction site. So during the 3 or 4 years of construction, the business school is going to have to go actually on top of Fishburne.
Really?
It's not a big deal. And the library here, Woodruff Library, that's going to have to go somewhere. That's not really my concern. It just needs to be out of my way as I'm building.
Right.
Although Emory has a campus on the move, I also have this idea. We'll construct this after 6 or 7 years here at this present site. Everything can return to the way it was.
Mm-hmm.
KA, as you know, is being torn down.
Yeah.
And so after several years, what we can do is put the new art building on a magic matter transporter, hover right over campus, go right on top of KA. As you know, KA is being torn down. There's room right there. Now over here, there's going to have to be more changes made to campus. It's just the way it goes. This building here, I don't know what it is. I don't care. It's gone. It's just gone. Now this building here, the PE Center, I'm going to need that to go because I want a pond right here, a really big pond for inspiration for the art students as they look out the window. And so the pond is going to go right there. The Woodruff PE Center is going to go on top of Dobbs. And over here, McDonough Field, I'll need this area. This can't just be any field. I'll need drainage field. It's a very different sort of field. Well, I'm going to need that to go. So we're going to put the field right over here on top of Long Street. It's about the perfect size. And there's some other stuff over here.
So it's staying on campus?
Yeah, it's staying on campus, right on campus. There's some other stuff over here that will probably be affected, but they're not as important. You know, Trimble, McTeer, Means. I just didn't include those at all. And so this is my vision for Emory in the new millennium.
I love it. I think it's great. I think you're brilliant.
Thank you so much
for coming.
I have a problem with this.
For Emory 2000, mm-hmm. You know, Emory in the new millennium, do you want to think inside the conventional building box that states with the laws of physics and thermodynamics, you can only have a building go so high and not put anything on top of it? Or do you, Morris Chesterton, want to think outside of that building
box.
Defy conventional wisdom.
Defy conventional.
Put PE Center on top of Dobbs and have your beautiful art building for Emory in the new millennium.
Beautiful. Hey, high five.
All right.
Do you all want a moment to consult?
I think we should have a moment to consult,
that's
frankly.
Fine.
I'm not sure.
It's
if
fine.
It's
you all
just,
talk
just,
about
it'll, this will just take a second.
Okay.
We don't want to be too hasty on this.
Oh, no, of course not. Of course
come on
not.
Over here. All right. No problem at all.
Okay. What is your problem?
I'm not sure about buildings on top of buildings.
It's the thing outside the box. Weren't you listening to him? Morris, he's brilliant. He's a genius. This man is making strides and leaps and bounds in architecture. He's my idol. I've been, for 5 years, I've been trying to build buildings, and he is my idol. He's the person I look up to.
You believe in him?
I believe in him. He's brilliant. This is a great idea. Trust me. I don't know how you don't see this.
Okay, I will trust you.
Great.
This is your ass.
Great. No, it's together. We're together.
All right.
All right.
You and I.
Now this road here, this will only be here for a few more days. Pretty soon, we're gonna cobble over all this, then cover it over with dirt, then rip it all up, pave it down, cobble it, pave it again, dirt it again, and then just rip it all up. It's just gone. After that.
You're gonna pave, rip up.
No. Pave, dirt, cobble, rip up. Dirt, rip up, cobble. Pave, dirt, pave, cobble, rip up.
Okay.
Yeah.
Repave.
Yeah, several times. Yeah. Does that sound
that's
okay?
That's necessary?
That's absolutely, it's vital, to the aesthetics of what we're trying to do here.
All right. I think we can handle that.
Okay. Okay, that's excellent. Shouldn't take too long.
No.
So.
Pinkerton, we've been talking, and we have a few problems with your new model for the campus.
Yes.
Seems to me it's not very well done, actually. It seems to us that you haven't really appropriately planned for campus events, such as transportation, handicap, accessibility, things we have to worry about. Mm-hmm. Quite frankly, we're concerned. And we're wondering, what can you offer us to combat these obvious deficiencies in your model?
Thought you might bring up this problem of accessibility on my new campus. So I've put together several ideas. I'm just going to call them out, give you a second to think about them. Roller coasters. Piggyback. Sky buckets, slip and slides, catapults. Dog sleds.
Just wait a second here. Do you have any idea how much money that would cost to train the dog and fly them in from Alaska and snow in the campus every day and hire the little Sherpa guys who ride it and whip the dogs? I mean, do you have any idea how much money that is? We're not running a big business here.
No, I understand, Mr. Pinkwash. You're sacrificing artistic vision for Emory 2000.
It's not about that.
For your budget.
I'm just saying, a lot of money, dogs. We could compromise, have little, chihuahuas and boards or something. I mean,
will the art building and the campus stay?
Yeah.
Okay.
I think that'll be fine.
All right, then I also had this idea. It's not nearly as aesthetic as the dog sleds or the catapults, okay. But it's doable, I think. We'll just have shuttle buses through all the pedestrian areas.
That's brilliant.
That's brilliant.
That's
shuttle
great.
Buses. And people can ride them.
Yeah, they just ride wherever they need to go. So does this... Does this work?
I think this will be fine.
All right.
It's been great.
Thank
great
you. To meet you all.
Great. I'm sorry about all the confusion.
No,
thank you so much
we'll
for your feedback.
Yeah,
thank
all
you
the help.
I appreciate
yeah, get,
that.
Get to work on all this.
You're brilliant. You're really
right.
A great man.
You all take care.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. That's a great man.
Yep.
It's a nice building.
That's beautiful.
It's beautiful.
Well, onto the aqueducts?
Yeah. Aqueducts.
Hi, I'm Clay Lockett. A lot of people have come up to me lately asking, how do we develop these wonderful characters like the Crocodile Hunter, Rick and Tony, Superfan? You know, I could say that the Shepherds write their own stuff, think about their own sketch, have writing sessions just composed of them, direct it, edit it, act it out. But seriously, people, no one's that good. No one. I gotta be straight with you people. The Shepherds? Yeah, we use comedy writers. They work 24/7, 365 in Cox Hall. You know those people who are always there, all the time? They work for us. You might be asking, who in the world has time? 24/7, 365? Who has that much time to write constantly for a sketch comedy show? I'll tell you who. Liberal arts majors. They got nothing else to do. Unfortunately, the original show, we used business school majors. But the need to be original, creative, and individualistic caused a few of them to short circuit. God, it was a mess. Well, let me introduce you to some of our very skilled staff writers. The very backbone behind every Shepherd show is the Shepherd staff writers. Like Charlotte, one of our best writers. Charlotte, what are you working on today?
Here's something, my liege.
Stop talking, Charlie. You're making me nervous here. Dr. Rhea and Professor Dyer get together and form a drink. You don't understand what's going on here. We write comedy. That was not comedy. I don't know what you're thinking. You know, dead gerbils and Tom Green might be funny in some countries, but not in this one. And you can never cast JC as a Roman emperor. It doesn't work. It doesn't work. She has a little bit more editing to do, and but I'm sure this will turn out great. So let's go on to another thing. Once a script is completed, the screenwriters take it to the Godfather Comedy, where he evaluates it, and the screenwriters wait in dreaded anticipation for his approval. Once a sketch is approved, it's go time. The director is called, the talent is called, the caterer, the lights, the best boy, Mark Paget, the sorority girls, the black pants, the gerbils, the PE center equipment room managers, they're all called to come to the scene to film the sketch.
Well, I hope that was informative. I hope everyone now appreciates all the work that and man hours that go into making a sketch. And hope everyone continues watching and keeps, you know, requesting the great. That's a blank cue card. Copy. I'd like to thank all the cast and crew of the Shepherds. And I'd also like to show our appreciation of all of our loyal fans and their wonderful support. Wonderful support you fans are. Do you have an in for me? I need an in. It's really just a technicality. Thank you. So y'all come back now, you hear? Did you write this? Who wrote this? Why are you giving this to me? Who's responsible for this?
What's wrong with that? I thought it sounded perfectly fine.
That stuff killed in Little Rock. You dumb shit.
You're right, Agent Mori. Fix it! No, fix it!
Hey.
That's right.
Hey, I'm Paco.
Can I call you Bill?
Okay.
Cool.
It's nice to meet you.
Where do you live, Bill?
I live in room 4 in this building.
This is 2.
I guess down the hall.
Let's be that way.
So where are you from?
I'm from New Jersey.
It's so weird. You're like the third person I've met from New Jersey. Everyone here seems like they're from New Jersey.
That can't possibly be.
I guess not.
You want to get some bagels and lox later?
Yeah. Well, what's lox?
Thinly cut raw salmon.
Awesome. Okay. Sure, and we can hang out.
Cool.
Okay.
I'll see you later, Bill.
See you later. It's nice to meet you.
Thank you, Bill.
All right. you live here too?
No, I'm the director.
Okay. It was nice meeting you. Hello? Hi. I guess you're my roommate? Okay. Well, hi. My name's Paco. Alright. It's nice to meet you. Looks like you already got the bottom bunk, huh? I was kind of hoping to talk to you about that, because I had this fear of heights, and I was wondering if maybe... No. Okay, I'm fine with the top bunk. Have you met Trey down the hall? He's from Jersey. Are you from Jersey, too? No, not you. Okay. Well, we're going out for bagels in a second. If you're coming, they have thinly sliced salmon they put on it. It's really good. You know what? I'll be right back. You know what? No. My mom told me not to be pushed around the first day of school by my roommate, and I'm not going to take it. I'm not going to take it from you just because you have a mask on. I want the bottom bunk, and I'm going to put my stuff there, and I'm going to put my stuff in the closet, and I'm going to move in, and we're going to be the best of friends, and it's going to be fine. And I'm going to play my CDs whenever I want to, and I might even walk around in the nude if I feel like it. Okay. No? Okay, the nude part. Okay, I won't. But the CDs, Can't we even talk about this? Can we take these posters out? My Star Trek posters are much cooler than this. Garbage. Oh, dude, is that Carrie Fisher? She's so hot. I think I like this closet better, so I'm gonna take this one, if that's okay with you. Oh, it's not? Well, that's just too bad, because I'm sticking up for myself. This closet looks real... You kill babies? So, you know that's Dooley's Ball? Have you heard about Dooley's Ball? Like, people get drunk and some people die and, like, there's dancing? It's crazy.
No.
You are from Jersey, aren't you? Did you go on any OEO trips? Who's your tailor? Sorry. So why do you wear this stupid mask anyway? You got, like, bad acne as a child? You got... face scar, or we fight for some intergalactic war or something. Here, blow. Hey, come on. Alright. Okay. Yeah. Alright. You feel better? Hey, let it out, man. It's okay. Hey. Wanna go get some bagels, some lox? It's thinly sliced salmon. Yeah? Alright. Come on. Here. I'll call you Lance. You're right. That's a bad idea. Call you what? Dark Lord? Yeah? Alright, come on. I'll buy you a cinnamon raisin bagel.
Fortune
dude,
paste and dough is like not, I don't know.
It's just tack on in bed of
ego.
Yeah.
What you got?
Wow.
Ryan, ready to us. Come on.
Okay. Your physical prowess is impressive in bed.
Cool, baby. Cool. That's awesome. Just say.
I'll be watching you till you die.
What?
In bed.
In bed.
Die in bed.
Cool,
see?
You're gonna die in bed.
That's really awesome. What is this crap? What's that?
It does sound kind of weird.
Yeah. It's weird.
Anyone else see that guy over there, or was that just me?
What?
There was a...
Where?
I don't see anybody.
Over there in the...
Over near the Asahi?
I...
Brian, did you see anything?
No.
Maybe I'm just... Whatever. Just,
I don't. Yeah, hold on to that. That's an interesting fortune there.
Yeah. Oh, man, I've got mine wet.
But, you guys ready to go?
Sure.
Yes. Kind of bugged out by now. Okay.
Get him something to drink.
I think he's watching.
He's watching. He's watching.
Be watching you till you die. Till you die? In bed? Yeah, you gonna be around your place for a while? Yeah, I just got this really weird feeling, it's just really weird, I'll talk to you about it. Yeah, I think I see a shuttle coming, I'll try to catch that and be right over, alright? Stay put. I'll be watching you till you die.
In bed.
What? What?
In bed.
What? In bed. What?
In bed.
Leave me alone. Stop following me. Leave. Diaspor. Go.
So you want me to leave?
Yeah. Yeah. Could you leave? Could you leave me alone?
Now?
Or sooner? Yeah, that'd be good. Yeah. Go! Now!
I'll be watching you till you die. I'll be watching you till you die. I'll be watching you till you die. I'll be watching you till you die.
Dude, that's gross.
It's pretty nasty.
At least you're alive.
Yeah,
man.
How you feeling?
I feel a little run down.
Mm. Yeah.
A little run down.
But I mean, like you said, it's good that you're okay, and goes to show you fortune cookies don't come true.
Yeah, what are you freaking
what
out
are you
about?
Worried about?
You guys were right. I just flipped out.
Fortune cookies, man.
Ow.
If you hadn't been thinking about that, you might not have gotten hit by the shuttle.
Yeah. That's what did it.
But yeah. All right, you want anything? You're hungry?
Go to the kid. Veggie burgers.
You want some veggie burgers?
I want some veggie burgers.
All right, we'll be back.
Some veggie burgers,
fries or something.
Coke,
duck,
Coke. All right. All right, we'll be back. We'll be back in a second.
Careful across the street. Thank you guys. I'll be watching you till you die.
Here you go. I'll be watching you till you die.
In bed.
What? What?
In bed.
Die in bed.
Cool,
see?
You're gonna die in bed.
I'll be watching you till you die. Till you die. In bed?
Guys! Guys, I know what the fortune means! Guys, don't leave me! Guys, come back! Oh, come on, guys, come back!
Well, I'm fed up and I need to go out of existence. So just down the road forever. Well, late, late night on the side of the road, I'm out of gas and I should have known better. Well, a guy showed up 25 years old, the oldest of his kids was such a mama's boy.
Help me, Dave. Ow.
I'm coming.
Dave.
I'm coming.
Dave, help
I'm
me.
Coming.
Dave, ow. Porn.
What are you doing?
Porn.
What are you doing right there, sir? Sir.
No.
Hey,
oh, hey,
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 I'm
hey,
Trey.
I'm Bill. No, Daddy, I can't have a car. Hang on. What do you mean my trust fund doesn't work?
Glad you're rolling, hi.
You wanna get some bagels and lox later?
What is lox?
It's a fish type supplement. That's what
it is.
Use your lunch. Then why do they call it sand?
Because
that can't be.
No, I'm from the south. Maybe I'll learn about Jersey one day.
Hopefully. Hopefully. It's a great state. The guard state.
I've heard you do gardening there.
I'll see you later, Bill.
It's like everyone here is from New Jersey.
That wouldn't happen. Couldn't happen. Not at a major university like this. Call some lox and salmon. Put
it's
some
not
nice cheese on it.
It's not lox and salmon. It's just lox.
Get